Hi, I'm Chris Wardlaw for Auto Vitel, and today we're reviewing the 2014 Chrysler Town & Country. Now on sales charts, the Town & Country and its corporate twin, the Dodge Grand Caravan, are the best-selling minivans in America. But the numbers don't tell the entire story. A lot of these end up in corporate fleets and in rental fleets rather than suburban driveways. Now, I've been driving this Town & Country for a week, shuttling my family all over Los Angeles, and I think the Town & Country deserves a lot more consideration than it gets. Every Town & Country has this 3.6-liter Pentastar V6 engine, makes 283 horsepower. That makes the Town & Country and the Dodge Grand Caravan the most powerful minivans in their class. These vans also are the heaviest in their class, and they're among the least fuel efficient. So with the power, the benefit of the power, come a few negatives. Tow rating is 3,600 pounds, which is 100 pounds more than some of the competing minivans. I don't know if that makes a big difference or not. And overall, I think the engine's fairly satisfying, but we'll talk about that a little bit more in a later segment. One thing I do want to point out is that the Town & Country, like other Chrysler products, has all the main maintenance points color-coded yellow. So it's really easy to find, even in the dark, it's easy to find the things that most people are looking for under the hood most of the time. Now, like all minivans, the Town & Country's got a lot of space inside. It's not quite as accommodating in terms of passenger space and cargo space as the Honda Odyssey or the Toyota Sienna, but it's close enough that the differences are actually pretty negligible. Now, I did not bring nearly enough things to fill this 33 cubic foot trunk that Chrysler supplies behind the third row seats. A couple of interesting things back here. Number one, there's this little embedded flashlight, which actually came in handy for me last night when I was trying to find something back here. There's a big light right here, and at night when you open this tailgate, it just floods the back of the vehicle with light. And then folding the seats is very easy. These seats fold right here into this well, and all the straps are numbered sequentially. It's a four-step process that can be completed with one hand, and they're all numbered. So basically, you know, number one is pull that, number two is pull that, number three is pull that, number four is pull that, and done, right? So if you do that on both sides, now you've created quite a bit of space back there. There's 83.3 cubic feet of space, which is as much as a mid-size crossover SUV with all the seats folded. So with a minivan, here's a benefit. You can put a bunch of stuff in it and four people. Okay, so one of the unique things about the Chrysler minivans is they have this stow and go seating arrangement. Power sliding side door moves open, and the great thing about stow and go is that you never have to take these seats out, unlatch them, lift them out of the van, carry them into the garage for storage when you want to maximize space. Instead, they fold into the floor. Now, it's not necessarily an easy process, but it is easier than hauling them into the garage. So the first thing you have to do is slide the front seat all the way up. You remove this carpeted mat. You open this underfloor bin, and then bam. Well, almost bam. Into the floor they go. Now, you do that on both sides, and this van carries about 143 cubic feet of space, which is more than a Chevy Suburban. Now I'm sitting in the Town & Country second row seat, and there are a few compromises associated with the handy stow and go seating design. Number one, these seats do not adjust fore and aft to create extra leg room if there's nobody in the third row seat. As you can see, I'm 6 feet tall, and my leg is basically flush against this hard seat back. The other issue is that when my child seats are installed in here and my kids are in the car, they kick the back of these seats. It's really aggravating. The other compromise is that these seats are kind of narrow for guys my size, and that's a requirement so that they will actually collapse and fold into the floor. One benefit is that there's a lot of thigh support. You can see how this angle is canted upwards, and that provides really decent thigh support for adults. My test car has, as an extra $100 option, Side window shades for the sliding doors and for the rear quarter glass. And while this van does come standard with dark tinted privacy glass, these additional sunshades are great for when you're carrying a newborn, because you do not want sunlight piercing those brand new eyeballs, do you? So one benefit of Stow & Go seats is because these don't move backwards, it's really easy for adults to get into the third row seat. A lever on the side of the seat, one touch, and it just folds itself up and pivots forward. A lot of space for me to get in. And then once I'm seated back here, the same really great thigh support is available. The seat actually sits up pretty high. There's a great view out. Note again, the optional side window shades on my van. And this van's got a big overhead console. The S model has a dual screen DVD Blu-ray player. And, you know, because I know kids like to play video games, you've got HDMI inputs here, power outlet, a 115 volt power outlet, a three-prong outlet, a couple of USB ports. there's really no reason for somebody to ride in this thing and not be entertained. Generally, I find the Town & Country to be pretty comfortable. The front captain's chairs have these inboard armrests. They're softly padded. The upper door panels, first of all, they're cut low for really good visibility, and they're softly padded and wide on the front, which makes it a great place to rest an arm while you're just piling miles on the freeway. This whole panel here, this armrest is softly padded. It's a good place to rest your arm as well. And the Town & Country S has this premium leather wrapped steering wheel with piano black accents. It looks good and it feels really good. Now, the rim is super thick though, so people with smaller hands might not really like that very much. All 2014 Town & Country models come with this Uconnect touchscreen infotainment system. It includes a basic Garmin navigation system. It's got a hard disk drive that you can store music on, or even, you know, put your favorite photos of your kids on there and display them on the screen. It's connected to the DVD player, so when the car is in park, you can actually watch whatever movie you're showing in the back on this screen. It works really well. The graphics are a little bit remedial for 2014. The screen is kind of small, but all of the buttons are really responsive to touch, and they're large enough so that people with giant fingers like me can easily touch them. So let's be upfront and honest about something right off the bat. Minivans aren't fun to drive, okay? This is an appliance. It's designed to do a specific thing, and that's haul a lot of people or stuff. Now, that said, my favorite thing about driving the Town & Country S is its sport-tuned suspension. That's what Chrysler says the suspension is. I would call it competently tuned. And the reason I say that is because, you know, it's not necessarily firm, but what it does do is it eliminates all the wafting and the wallow and the roll associated with a regular Town & Country that makes the regular Town & Country feel like you're driving around on four underinflated tires. This van instead, it feels taut, it feels somewhat athletic. It can go around a corner without squealing and announcing to everybody that you're going around a corner. So if you're going to buy a Chrysler Town & Country and you can live without all the bells and whistles that are available on the higher trim levels, I recommend getting the S model. Now, it sounds like there's a lot of really good reasons to choose the Town & Country, and there are, especially because this particular model is aging. It's 7 years old, and it's usually available with big rebates, cut rate financing, great lease deals. So it is compelling, but I'm gonna recommend a different minivan, and here's why. Minivans are almost always purchased to haul families. And if you're a parent like me, you know that one of the most important things that you have to do is protect your family. The Town & Country gets decent crash test scores, but there's another model in the segment that does better, and that's the Honda Odyssey. The Odyssey got a top safety pick plus rating recently, which means that it passed the new small overlap frontal impact test with flying colors. Now, if the Odyssey, the Alabama sourced Odyssey, doesn't really do it for you, this is really worth a look. It's easily competitive with the Toyota Sienna, far better than the Kia Sedona, and depending on how you like the Quest styling and the way the seats work, this is probably a better deal here as well. If you don't want to pay the premium for the Chrysler brand, you can always get the Dodge Grand Caravan, which has a lot of the same stuff for a slightly lower price. For Auto by Tell, I'm Chris Wardlaw, and I'll see you back here next time.